You're watching News Night, and in a shocking incident, the woman who had accused BJP MLA Kuldeep Singh Sengar of raping her in Unnao was injured in a road accident in Uttar Pradesh's Raibareli district. Now, the survivor was accompanied by her aunt, who lost her life on the spot in the accident. Shockingly, the number plate of the truck which was involved in the accident has been and was blackened. The family of the rape survivor have called this a conspiracy, alleging there was an attempt to murder. They're also demanding an independent CBI probe into the incident. The family of the victim has spoken out and have said that they suspect foul play behind what the police are still, after all of this, calling an accident. Take a look.
विधायक ने करवाया
क्या नाम है विधायक जी
विधायक की साहब कुलदीप सिंह
का आप क्या चाहते हैं
ये अंदर है इनके लोग मनाई तो नहीं अंदर है सर
फोन भी है
इनके इनके पास अंदर फोन भी है
इनके पास फोन भी है
ये बैठे बैठे सारा काम वहीं से कर रहे हैं आप क्या
जानकारी मिली थी कि मेरी माँ और मेरी मौसी बहन और एक लोग मतलब कि बहन ये चार लोग जो है महेश सिंह से मिलने जा रहे थे रायबरेली जेल उसके बाद जो है वहाँ पे क्या हुआ मुझे ये सूचना मिली कि तुम्हारी माँ और तुम्हारी मौसी जो है ट्रामा सेंटर आई हुई हैं और माँ भी रायबरेली में ही वहीं पे ख़त्म हो गई जो हुआ है ये किसी ने करवाया गया है
And the main accused in the rape of a minor trial is yet to start. Remember, the rape survivor's father was also beaten up after the case came to light, allegedly beaten by Singer's family while in police custody. He died in the district hospital. There's also witnesses, of course, who claim that the truck came from the wrong side as well. The police, however, is still taking this as an accident, although they claim investigation is underway about the mysterious circumstances under which this accident occurred. Here's ADG Law and Order of Uttar Pradesh. Take a look.
Truck hai, wo seize kar liya gaya hai. जो ट्रक का ड्राइवर है क्लीनर है और मालिक है उनको भी हमने कस्टडी में ले लिया है जब ये घटना हुई है उस टाइम बहुत तेज बारिश हो रही थी तो ड्राइवर का ये कहना है कि उसी बारिश में वो जो रोड जो है उसमें बीच में डिवाइडर नहीं है जो इनकी जाने वाली रोड है फ्रॉम रायबरेली टू फतेहपुर और जो गाड़ी की आने वाली रोड है वो फ्रॉम उन्नाव टू रायबरेली तो आमने सामने की गाड़ियां थी उन आमने सामने गाड़ियों में टक्कर हुई है जो लोकल फील्ड यूनिट की टीम है वो भी मौके पर है वो घटना को रिक्रिएट कर रहे हैं और इस घटना को रिक्रिएट करने के बाद ये एस्टेब्लिश हो जाएगा कि क्या रॉन्ग साइड से आ रहा था क्या किस तरह से क्या सीक्वेंस ऑफ इवेंट था जिसकी वजह से एक्सीडेंट हुआ है जो गाड़ी का नंबर प्लेट हाइड करने के बारे में गाड़ी के मालिक का यह कहना है कि उसने ये गाड़ी फाइनेंस करा रखी थी और फाइनेंस जिन लोगों से कराई थी उन लोगों को उसने पैसे नहीं दिए थे इस वजह से उसने गाड़ी का नंबर हाइड किया हुआ था
Joining us right now is Naveen Chomal. He's a lawyer along with Ashutosh Mishra. He's a political analyst. Mr. Chomal, I'd like to start with you. There have been allegations that the proximity Mr. Sengar enjoys, that he enjoys with not just the BJP that is in power in the state, also at the center, and the probe that is currently going on is also being overseen by the UP police. How can it be that one after the other mysterious developments in the case occur and even though Kuldeep Sengar is in jail, the family members of the survivor accuse him of having a cell phone inside and having all that he needs to manufacture or at least start to make sure that this a conspiracy, as they call it, hatch that conspiracy from inside the jail. How can anyone concede that the UP police, which is under the UP government, which happens to be the BJP, can conduct a free, honest and independent probe? Why doesn't the BJP and the UP government, Mr. Sengar, remember, is a BJP MLA, why don't they suspend Mr. Sengar from the primary membership of the party until and unless he clears his name after due process of law? Only then will anyone believe, Mr. Chomal, that there's an independent probe.
Athar, see, I respect all your concerns. That's why I like to have some proper time to put my viewpoint.
Sure.
Sir, please appreciate that in today's world, where our media is also so very vigilant and active, my salutes to the Indian media and our fairness. Please trust that this particular BJP government means business and they are very serious about running a very clean government in the nation. So please don't mistake them with what has been happening in the past with the previous governments like Congress, SP or TMC. But having said so, your concerns are very much serious, and please appreciate the UP police has also registered this to be a case of murder. Of course, murder in the form of accident, and they are going to probe it. So whatever may be the offhand questions given to the police, and there may be some reactions from the police, that is not the part of their investigation. So let us not take that to be the result of the investigation.
But Mr. Chuma,
ultimately, we can assure the nation that this investigation is going to be very fair.
Chumal, and these assurances are hollow. I'll tell you why.
If he is found to be guilty, action will be taken against him.
Mr. Chumal, all of these assurances are all well within whenever we speak about this on television and all. But just imagine the plight of that particular family. First, she was allegedly raped by a person
you
in
are
power.
Right, sir.
No, one second. Allow me. Allow me to finish.
And that is why,
sir, allow me to finish.
Fully assured.
Allow me to
at
finish.
At least
sir.
Under the BJP government, there will be no hanky-panky.
Sir, allow me to finish, sir. Imagine the plight of this family, and imagine how the sequence of events have shaped up. Number one, the victim, the survivor, alleges that a man in power, who's an elected representative of the ruling party, raped her. Then her father is beaten up inside police custody, UP police custody, mercilessly. Then he dies of his injuries. Then Kuldeep Sengar, who's in jail currently, has been accused of holding a cell phone inside, which is also clearly a violation of the rules. Then mysteriously, sir, this truck comes out of nowhere, which is also carrying two witnesses of the CBI probe, her aunt and her mother, one of whom dies on the spot. Now, can you imagine how anyone in this particular family, they've seen enough, will believe your assurances or anybody else's assurances for that matter? They're now saying we want an independent probe into this accident slash murder, whatever you want to call it. And clearly, it is incumbent on the BJP, of which Mr. Sengar is a member, to at least tell him to step down while the investigation is on. What's the harm in that? If he's innocent, he'll prove his innocence and then he can rejoin the BJP. How will you inspire confidence in anybody from that family and anyone watching right now, anyone in this country, when proximity to the ruling party is making sure that everyone believes he will get away scot-free?
Athar, see, the rape case was one part of it, and this dastardly incident of the accident that has come to the fore yesterday only. So please let us give some time to the party, let the party get the proper information about the matter, and I am sure the party will act in upright and a most fair manner.
Sir, the police role is also under question, sir. I'm sorry, but she was assigned certain individuals for her protection. Where were they? The UP police has absolutely no answer why they didn't accompany her. Now they're saying hamare jawanon ne kaha hai ki humko bola gaya saath mat aaiye, to kya unki duty wahi khatam ho jati hai? Ye iska jawab bhi UP ke ADG Lucknow ADG ne nahi diya. That's all I'm trying to say, that this is all under question, under a cloud, because the proximity of Mr. Sengar and the ruling party and the ruling elite, his brothers have been roaming around with BJP MPs, with UP Chief Minister Adityanath. His sister went to his functions, campaigned for him. Ashutosh Mishra, can the UP police assure anybody at this point, after so much has happened in this particular case, that there will be an unbiased probe in this? I think not, Mr. Mishra.
I totally agree with you. And just you were asking the question about Mr. Sengar being suspended. Let's remember, BJP is the same party which has got Pragya Singh Thakur, a terror accused, elected as MP. So their being in cahoots with such elements is nothing new. In fact, that Hamidpur MLA in UP has just been disqualified because he was there was a proven case of murder against him. Now, ever since Adityanath has taken over as the UP Chief Minister, we are seeing the situation going from bad to worse. And Mr. Amit Shah, in fact, confessed that Mr. Adityanath was advised against appointing Mr. Adityanath because Mr. Adityanath was not competent enough. And he's proving it true now. So in Lucknow, we have UP police shooting down an Apple executive. Here, a person can go and kill injure.
I'm just worried about imagine the plight of that family, sir.
And I
also want to introduce Advaita Kala, who's an author who joined us on the program right now.
Police,
yes.
A don a don was sent out of UP because under Supreme Court orders, because he was still making life hell for people outside, okay, and even for
so let me go to Advaita.
That is the situation.
Advaita, this particular case has reached a stage where nobody really, clearly nobody in that family of the survivor of the rape, alleged rape that she slain, is wants to believe, first of all, that they have any recourse to an independent probe, even though the rape case is under CBI probe. Just look at the sequence of events, Advaita. First, after she accused Kuldeep Sengar of rape, suddenly her father was taken into police custody on what the family claimed is a baseless case, beaten up badly, died under police custody. Then what happens is that suddenly two witnesses in the CBI probe are in the car, the PSOs assigned to them do not accompany them, and a very mysterious accident slash attempt to murder, as the UP police is calling it right now. That girl is critically injured, her mother is critically injured, the aunt is dead. Now, are they out of line when they say we do not believe the UP police's probe, and shouldn't Mr. Sengar step down or be suspended temporarily if possible from his party, because proximity to the ruling party there of his family members, his brother and sister to the UP chief minister, does not inspire confidence? What's wrong in that query?
Nothing wrong at all. I think we're seeing a travesty of justice unfolding in front of our very eyes. The fact that step by step, this case has been handled in the most inept manner and has exhibited every sign of bias that one can expect. And this latest act, if we don't know what caused the action, the accident, that much is true. But certainly it's very, very sinister. It's like the father Mullakal case in Kerala, where again there was a rape accused, and there was a father in Punjab who again died mysteriously while the father Mullakal was out on bail. So you're seeing this repetition, you know, when it comes to these kind of crimes against women. How are women advised every time they take a step in this direction? They are told that don't do it, don't say anything, because you will jeopardize your personal safety and that of your family. Now, that isn't an urban legend. This case has amply proved that that is exactly what happened.
Well, the worst has come true in this case. You're absolutely right. Advaita, the worst fears have come true in this case. And I just really quickly want to ask Mr. Chomal, and also we also want to show our viewers what the opposition has been saying about this. They've slammed the Yogi Adityanath government, demanding a CBI probe into the incident. Here are some reactions we got throughout the day today after we spoke to the police. Take a look.
My political affiliations, which will always be opposing BJP and RSS, but you know, as a human being, I want to know why there's such a silence from BJP ranks. You are in power here, you're in power there. Where is your concern for this teenager?
Police adhikari wo bhasha bol rahe hain jo sarkar bulwana chahti hai. Sarkar ki bhasha hi adhikari bol rahe hain. Sarkar nispaksh jaanch kare ya ho tab jaakar usko nyay milega. Socho aap hi ek beti ko FIL लिखाने के लिए उसे आत्मदाह मुख्यमंत्री के घर के सामने करना पड़ा था. इससे बड़ा दुर्भाग्य क्या हो सकता है?
बदनाम करने के लिए बंगाल को बारे में कहते हैं, लेकिन क्या चल रहा है यूपी में, क्या सरकार का कोई जानकारी है? अगर जानकारी नहीं है तो इसको तो देखना चाहिए कि लिंचिंग का नाम पे आज जो हो रहा है और जो उन्नाव के बारे में हुआ है,
जो दोषी हैं उनको कठोर से कठोर सजा दी जाए. नहीं तो एक गलत संदेश जाता है कि एक तो बेचारी महिला के साथ गलत काम हुआ और उसके बाद अब उसको न्याय मिलने की बजाय उसके परिवार के एक 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 सदस्य जो है वो इस तरह से हिंसा का शिकार हो रहा है.
जिस तरह से उस ट्रक के नंबर प्लेट को काला किया गया था, इससे ये साफ तौर पर झलकता है कि जो उपयुक्त है उनको ये संरक्षण देने की साजिश है.
Mr. Chomal, again, I'm going to ask you at the cost of sounding repetitive here, what is stopping the BJP, either in the state or the center, to temporarily, I'm asking them to temporarily suspend the membership or the primary membership of Mr. Sengar to the party, because they're both in power at the center and the state, and the proximity of Mr. Sengar to the BJP state leadership and the central leadership, along with the sequence of events here and how horribly this case has unfolded, is making people ask the question, why why cannot Mr. Sengar step down till the investigation is over? If he's innocent, he'll prove he's innocent, then he can rejoin the party. What's stopping the BJP from taking action against him? After all, conflict of interest is written large all over this case.
Sir, please appreciate, this accident has occurred just yesterday only. So let the party get the proper information
but
about
so
the case,
about the
his
accident,
involvement in the matter.
Look at the
and
sequence
the
of events.
I'm sure the party will be.
But look at the sequence of events. The victim had to go and try a self-immolation bid outside the chief minister's house to get the FIR registered. Then a father is taken into police custody, brutally beaten up. He dies in police custody. Then they allege that Kuldeep Sengar, who has a cell phone inside the jail, is organizing this. She was getting threatening phone calls despite being assigned police security. What was the police doing if they were still getting threat phone calls after being assigned police security? Obviously, something is wrong.
See, we are, as an experienced criminal lawyer, we are used to reckless allegations also from the side of victims. Some their case may be genuine, but then there is something we have to separate chaff from the wheat, and there is a possibility then certain allegations of getting threats may be exaggerations also. So the police is definitely
saying,
looking into
you're saying
it.
They're making it up. Come on, Mr. Chomal, have some sympathy. Have a little empathy for somebody who was a minor when she was allegedly raped. Have some empathy, sir, for this family where the father has died in police custody. Now an aunt is dead in a brutal accident. The victim herself is fighting life and death right now. Have some empathy, sir, please.
Even a word against the family.
No, you're saying, you know,
I'm totally sympathizing with it.
Advaita Kala, is this acceptable?
Let's remember, you know, last year, it was only last year during the Me Too movement when there were allegations against MJ Akbar, and those were allegations, okay, nothing more than that at that point of time. The witnesses or the accusers have been secure after that. But because there was a conflict of interest and he was in a position of power, I think the BJP did the right thing by relieving him of his duties.
Yes.
As a minister in the cabinet, and that was the right thing to do. So I do not understand why Mr. Sengar, who is an MLA, who is somebody who was hopped from other parties, has such a hold over them after the death. Let's remember, the father was also killed in custody.
Yes.
Or died in custody, however you want to word it. So this has been a case wherein there has been an inordinate amount of delay in terms of even registering the FIR. Now, why would that happen? Unless this person had some contacts in the right places for the wrong reasons. And I think this has been clear from day one. So I believe that Yogi Adityanath, the first thing he really has to do is relieve this person of his association with the Bharatiya Janata Party.
Fair enough. Advaita, in one line, I'm going to ask you, it's a yes or no answer. Do you think proximity is prejudicing the probe? Yes or no?
I think it is enough. There is enough proximity to assume that it is.
Okay, fair enough. Ashutosh Mishra, quickly then.
No, my problem with what you are saying is that people who are close to power centers, even if they are out of party, they can get away. And when there is a vested interest of power, the party which is in power, we have seen in the past that cases have fallen flat either in courts and people have got away and even occupied higher constitutional positions. So you're saying that just Mr. Sengar getting away from the being dismissed or suspended from BJP will solve the issue? It will not. Because if you remember, Sakshi Maharaj visited him. So even if he is not a part of BJP, there are people in BJP who might help him. So how can you say
answer that,
just
Mr. Chomal? Mr. Chomal, answer that. Sakshi Maharaj is sitting MP.
There are
people who have got away. To allege the party against it.
No, but answer this. A sitting MP goes and visits Mr. Sengar in jail. His brother campaigns and goes and visits Mr. Sakshi Maharaj. His sister campaigns for the chief minister during the Lok Sabha campaign as well. So clearly proximity is an issue here. We cannot just hide our heads in the sand like ostriches and say, no, everything will be fine. The probe will be completely unbiased. There is a problem here and we have to admit it.
No. Athar, sir, please appreciate. proximity may be there between Mr. Sengar personally, and he must be having personal one-to-one relation with senior BJP leaders in the party also. That is one aspect which we cannot overlook. But you can trust that whatever proximity this man must be having, it will not help him in influencing the investigation.
Sir, according to the family, he has a cell phone inside jail premises. The mother, of course, who's also injured, has spoken to us today.
Let us take it with a nice pinch of salt.
As I told you before, the family and the victim both were getting threats, live threats. Sir, live threats while they were assigned police personnel for their security. So clearly, all of those who wanted to threaten them did not get deterred by police presence around the family. So clearly, there is a rot somewhere. And you're saying, absolutely fine, nobody will be able to get away on all that. All that sounds very well, sir, but it's not practical. The family will never believe that the UP police can carry out an independent probe when they're not even ready to admit in the afternoon that this was or could be a conspiracy to attempt to murder. It was only after questions were raised that they even wanted to label it as a possible conspiracy or attempt to murder. At first, they only said this was an accident, nothing else. We have visuals, by the way, on the screen right now, Sakshi Maharaj visiting Mr. Sengar in jail, sir. We have put them on the screen right now.
To commit a murder, definitely police have taken the step of registration of case of murder against Mr. Sengar. So, please appreciate, we like ordinary people can very quickly level allegations. But the men in uniform, they have to act very cautiously.
No, understood.
So they have started with
the. I'm not saying people in uniform can act recklessly or rashly. All I'm saying is to inspire even a semblance of confidence in this particular case. Somebody has to take action. We have to separate the proximity and make sure the proximity is not a factor. Ashutosh Mishra, very quickly.
Athar, in the past, we have seen senior BJP leaders getting away with murder accusations because the witnesses turned hostile in the court. And their political career has taken off after that. We are all aware of it. Now, in this particular case, why do you presume that his being just suspended will solve the issue? Here, the problem is, again, that in this case it's worse because the witnesses are being eliminated, they're dying in accidents, so there will be no witness. They don't even have to turn hostile. That is the problem here. And how do you presume that UP police will be unbiased when again and again we are seeing that dons are operating from within the jails, and we have even photographs are there of criminals showing off guns.
We have the visual of Sakshi Maharaj visiting Mr. Sengar in jail.
Things have gone down, sir.
Putinous thing and discerning very things.
No, I'm sorry, sir. This does not inspire any confidence. The BJP must take a call, either the state leadership or the central leadership, of whether or not they want to have somebody who has very serious charges against him, who's in jail and is now being accused of hatching a conspiracy to one by one eliminate witnesses that could put him behind bars for a very long time. I'm using the word could because it's still under investigation. But clearly, the government has not taken a call. The UP police has inspired absolutely no confidence as far as this case is concerned. And I'm sorry to say, Mr. Chomali, even the Chief Minister has inspired no confidence. If he can be part of a campaign where Kuldeep Sengar's sister and brother are campaigning for him, then you can imagine, very well imagine, what the family might be going through in terms of whether or not they believe the UP police or even the UP government at that matter. Kuldeep, thank you for joining us. Ashutosh Mishra, Naveen Chomal and Advaita Kala on News 9. That's all we have right now. We'll take a short break.